गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज आवर फर्स्ट लेक्चर ऑफ चैप्टर 2, किंग्स फार्मर्स एंड टाउन। टुडे वी डिस्कस टॉपिक 1 एंड 2 ऑफ दिस चैप्टर। फॉर दिस डिस्कशन यू हैव टू ओपन पेज नंबर 28 ऑफ योर बुक वेयर यू गॉट दीज टॉपिक्स। आफ्टर द एंड ऑफ हरप्पन सिविलाइजेशन सेवरल डेवलपमेंट अकर इन डिफरेंट पार्ट ऑफ द सब कॉन्टिनेंट इंडिया सच एज ऋग्वेदा वॉज कंपोज्ड along the Indus and its tributaries, agricultural settlement emerged in several parts of the subcontinent, new mode of disposal of dead bodies like making megalithis a strong stone structure emerged. By 600 BCE, growth of new cities and kingdoms also emerged. 600 BCE became a major turning point in the early Indian history. Growth of 16 Mahajanpadas was marked during this time. Many were ruled by kings. Some known as Ganas or Sanghas were oligarchies where power was shared by a number of men, often collectively called Rajas. Between 600 BCE and 400 BCE, Magadha became the most powerful Mahajanpada. Emergence of Mauryan Empire, Chandragupta Maurya, founder of the empire, extended his control up to Afghanistan and Balochistan. His grandson Ashoka, the most famous ruler, conquered Kalinga. Variety of sources to reconstruct the history of the Mauryan Empire. Archaeological finds, especially sculpture, Ashoka's inscription, literary sources like Indica account are used by the archaeologists to describe the activities which was happened during the time of 600 BCE. Topic 1, Princeship and Piyadasi. In the 1830s, James Princeship, an officer in the Mint of East India Company, deciphered Brahmani and Krosti, two scripts used in the earliest inscriptions and coins. He found that most of these mention a king referred to as Piyadasi, meaning pleasant to behold. There were a few inscriptions which also referred to the king as Ashoka, who was one of the most famous rulers known from Buddhist text. Topic 2, the earliest states. The 16 Mahajanpadas. The 6th century BCE is an era associated with early states, cities, the growing use of iron, the development of coinage, etc. These 16 states known as Mahajanpada, although the list vary, some names such as Vazi, Magadha, Kushala, Kuru, Panchala, Gandhara and Avanti occur frequently. Clearly, these were amongst the most powerful Mahajanpadas. While most Mahajanpadas were ruled by the kings, some, known as Ganas or Sanghas, were oligarchies where power was shared by a number of men, often collectively called Rajas. Each Mahajanpada had a capital city which was often fortified. From 6th century BCE onwards, Brahmanas began composing Sanskrit texts known as Dharma Sutras. These laid down norms for rulers who were ideally expected to be Kshatriyas. Some states acquired standing armies and maintained regular bureaucracies. Others continued to depend on militia recruited more often than not from the peasantry. First among us the 16 Mahajanpadas. Magadha. Between the 6th and 4th century BCE, Magadha, which is in present-day Bihar, became the most powerful Mahajanpada. It was a realm where agriculture was especially productive. Besides, it was also rich in natural resources and animals like elephant, which was an important part of the army, could be procured from the forest spread of Rin, Ganga and its tributaries provided a means of cheap and convenient communication. Magadha attributed its power to the policies of individual ruthlessly ambitious kings of Magadha, whom names are Bimbisara, Ajatasatru and Mahapadmananda, are the best known, and their minister who helped implement their policies. Rajgaha, the Prakrit name of the present day Rajgir in Bihar, was the capital of Magadha initially. In the 4th century BCE, the capital was shifted to Pataliputra, present day in Patna. Thank you. Stay home, stay safe. Try to make a nice day. Goodbye.